Hi everyone, I'm Cody, W3AMG with BridgeCom Systems, and today we're going to be showing you how to adjust the sound or change the alert tones on your Anytone radio. So it's really simple. All we need is the radio here. We've got that turned on. We'll go ahead and plug it into the computer, just like so. Plug that into the radio and read from it as normal. To do that, just go ahead and go up to the COM port settings. There we go. Make sure it's connected, which it is. And then click the button to the left of that that says read from radio. Go ahead and click OK and we'll read the other data. There we go, read data complete. So click OK and then go ahead and click on optional settings. Once you're here, you'll want to go to the alert tone section. Now in this section, we have a few different tones. You can see there's a lot of them are pretty obvious what they do. So there's a few I'll go over here. The talk permit tone right here. That is for the tone you'll hear when you're actually pressing the PTT. So the sound that happens when you press the PTT, that is what this does. So you can change that, you know, for just digital, analog, or for both, or for off. Then you have your idle, analog idle channel tone down here. You can turn that on or off. So the idle channel tone is the sound it displays when the channel actually becomes free. So you have the option to turn that on and off. And here we have the digital call reset tone. You can turn that on or off. That's the tone it plays after keying that digital channel. So you really have endless options on what you can customize here with your tones. Now, if you want to actually change any of these tones, you can actually literally change the sound of them as well. So we have the frequency here and the period, that's how long they last. So like for our call permit tone, let's say we want to make this 900 instead, we can play that and it's going to sound different than if we had it set to 700. Same goes for your idle channel tone and your call reset tone. And there we have it. So once you've made your adjustments, just go back up here and then go ahead and click on write to radio, click OK, and then write the other data. After that, you're all set.